The Nike SB Dunk Low, though today an uncontested favorite, once fell victim to lackluster popularity a few years back. After many notable collaborations, the 2002-born silhouette slowly faded into obscurity, following the early 2010s attempts at turning it into something almost too playful. And though most people incorrectly refer to all dunks as SB Dunks, the base model was actually born years prior to the 2000s as a basketball staple. Its colorways, which quickly toured through all of the core Nike universities, became prolific since and have more recently made their way back to the spotlight via a few low-top retros. Officially launched in 2002, the SB Dunk quickly became an icon, thanks to the plethora of names it worked with early on. Alongside, the silhouette amassed more than a handful of legendary colorways that are now as elusive as they are expensive, the Heinekens, Pigeons, Og Supremes, and Lobsters to name a few. While many will stay untouched for collector's sake, the brand has gradually reopened conversations with past partners to revisit the model in different ways. Supreme, for instance, moved on from their past motifs to create something more signature to the brand as it stands today. Jewel swooshes and a bevy of metallic finishes marked a trio that objectively helped spearhead the SB Dunk's meteoric rise back to the forefront. Diamond Supply is owed quite a bit of credit, as well as their recent F&F Canary Dunk, was one of the first to eclipse the four-figure mark in late 2018. Then, in what was effectively the most nostalgic nod to the past, Concept released brand new takes of their beloved Lobster lineup, with special access points taking place across New York City. Assimilated well into current popular culture, the SB Dunk has not only dressed the feet of Travis Scott, but has also worked with the artist to create what is considered to be one of the best collaborations of 2020. Sold out near instantly, the release, whose upper was marked with literal rope laces, removable layers, and a slew of aggressive prints, was controversial in its response, as fans throughout the nation rang up participating skate shops constantly. Then, to an even larger appeal, the brand began working with ice cream purveyor Ben & Jerry's for one of the wildest releases.